Hi guys, welcome back to GK Code Labs. Today I want to discuss a topic that is important from an interview perspective if you are going for a Hadoop admin role. The concept of this topic is very important for a Hadoop admin to understand. But for developers also, I would suggest please watch this and understand the concept, as you also might face frequent issues related to this very now and then. We are going to understand what is safe mode in Hadoop. To set the context, I can say that our name node in HDFS can sometimes go to safe mode. But how, why, and when? Let's understand with this simple diagram. We have a name node. Suppose we have three data nodes. You might already know that a name node handles all the data nodes in a Hadoop cluster, and our data might be replicated to two or more data nodes in a Hadoop cluster. Let's say we have two blocks of data, block A and block B, and consider our replication factor is 3. So across the data nodes, block A might be stored something like this. First replication of block A is on data node 1, second replication is on data node 2, and third replication is on data node 3. Similarly, for block B, suppose first replication is on data node 3, second replication is on data node 1, third replication is on data node 2. Once all this replication is done, a complete snapshot of all the data nodes is taken at regular intervals for name node reference, and we call it FS image, or you can say file system image. Considering a scenario, if a cluster is started, the name node reads this FS image file to understand what was the position of blocks and replications till any last point of time. Once the name node reads the FS image file, the name node also expects the response from all the data nodes regarding what replicated blocks they have, so that name node could understand that no data is lost since last point of time. Sometimes what happens, the report that data nodes are supposed to give to name node, that is not sent or corrupted or missed. This might happen with one or multiple data nodes. In such cases, the name node is not sure that whatever replicated blocks were there in data node 1 or data node 2, are they still there, or they are missed, or is it corrupted? And if in such scenarios we are requesting to write or create something on the HDFS, name node could not make proper decisions that can we replicate those blocks onto data node 1 or 2. So that is why this is the HDFS internal architecture, that if name node faces such scenarios, it automatically moves to safe mode. This safe mode is basically a read-only mode. You can read the data, but you cannot write on it. I'll show you a practical demo on this. Let me go to my Cloudera quickstart VM. Now if I run my HDFS command to list my HDFS root directory, you can see it is properly listing all my files and folders. Now let's try to create a directory onto this. Here you can see such kind of message, cannot create directory, name node is in safe mode. Also, not only this, all the tools that use HDFS for the operation, you cannot work on them in such cases. Suppose, as you know, Hive uses HDFS to store all the table information. Let me try to initiate Hive. You can see we are getting similar HDFS errors, cannot create directory, number of live data nodes 1, has reached minimum number 0. Safe mode will be turned on automatically once these thresholds are reached. I'll tell you many reasons that could cause this behavior of name node. There could be many reasons behind this. As I already told you, name node does not receive a feedback from data nodes. That could be one of the reasons. Minimum number of replication of blocks are not reached. So this could also be one of the reasons. Or also, if data node is not giving a feedback, name node could not make out that are there only one replica of that block or there are multiple. Data node don't have enough memory to store any more data. This can also be one of the reason. Missing blocks are greater than a limit. If name node could not make out that how many number of blocks are missing, it can go to safe mode. Also, at the time of admin activities or the maintenance activities, the admin team can manually move the name node to safe mode. These are the few basic operations that you can do to work with safe mode. HDFS DFS admin hyphen safe mode get option will give you the status, is it in safe mode or not. Enter option will manually move your name node to safe mode, and leave option forcefully bring your name node out from the safe mode. So if you are practicing at home and you find your name node in safe mode, you can easily go with this third command, safe mode leave, and continue with your work. But if you have admin responsibility, you should not just blindly hit the safe mode leave option, because this might cause serious issues and a big loss of data. You should check all the HDFS and data node logs before doing that. I thought it is important to discuss this topic because many a times developers or admins face such kind of issue and they just Google it and find this third option and they hit it blindly. So I would suggest you should analyze the logs first, considering the importance of your data, before taking any such step. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you like this video, please hit that like button and please subscribe to my channel if you have not already done. I hope to see you in my next video. Thank you.